Students, welcome to the lecture session on hydroelectric power plants. Today I am going to discuss the principle of working of a hydroelectric turbines. As already I have discussed in last video lecture, reaction turbine and impulse turbine. Let us once overview on this. So water turbines are Pelton wheel, as already I discussed, it is a impulse type, and Francis, Keplon and propeller types are reaction turbines. Okay. So here once I will review on the term reaction turbines, why it is called Francis turbine. So in this, the water flows radially inward and changes to downward direction while passing through the runner. As the water passes over the rotating plates of the runner, both pressure and velocity of water are reduced. This causes reaction force which drives the turbine. I repeat here, as the water passes over the rotating blades of the runner, both pressure and velocity of the water are reduced. This causes a reaction force which drives the turbine. So this is the another one image, water it will be enters in axial flow react, the principle of axial flow reaction. In axial flow turbines, the water flows through runner along the direction parallel to the axis of rotation of the runner. The water at the inlet, of the turbine possesses both kinetic energy as well as the pressure energy for effective rotation of the blades in hydropower station. Okay. So one more here figure we can see. This is water which it will be enters through this penstock, and this is the blades, and it creates the rotation in this direction, water, the pressure, well, it will be entered here, and if it will be mechanical power, if it will be developed, and it will be connected to the generator, and generator, it will be further, it will be goes to the transformer and electricity. Here the construction detail I will show you in a slide. Here you can see. So in this you can see here, this is the guide wheel. So water which it will be enters in this, so that the rotation it will be take place in one proper direction. So here in this one more image of the reaction turbine. So this is a guide vane and spiral case. This is spiral case. If you are looking to this figure, you will come to know the complete spiral case is this. Next one is Keplon turbine. Keplon turbine this is also reaction type. The difference between Keplon and Francis we will discuss here. Comparison between Keplon and Francis turbine, both are reaction turbines. Efficiency of Keplon turbine is higher. Keplon turbine is more compact in cross section and has higher rotational speed that of identical Francis turbine. And one more here difference is, in Keplon turbine the water flow is axial and in Francis turbine is in its radial. This is the very important point, please note it, the water flow is axial in Keplon, in Francis turbine is radial. The runner plates in Kaplan turbines are less in numbers. Okay. Next point is the comparison. Specific speed of Kaplan turbine is 2 to 3 times more than the Francis turbine. Next, I will discuss what is the specific speed. Okay, so here you have to note it. Kaplan turbines is 2 to 3 times is more. Okay, Kaplan turbines specific speed is more than Francis turbine. Friction losses in Kaplan turbine is less. Francis turbine is require medium head while Kaplan turbines are low head plants. Next one, water turbine is felt on wheel turbine. It is impulse turbine. Okay. So this is the one figure it will be shown, felt on wheel. This is operating head. It consists of a wheel fitted with elliptical buckets along its periphery. If you are looking here, this is the periphery. There will be a number of buckets are fitted. The force of water jet striking the buckets, the wheel drives the turbine. The quantity of water jet falling on the turbine is controlled by means of a needle. Okay, here we are controlling the flow of water through the needle. Okay, the movement of the needle is controlled by the governor. Okay, I will discuss afterwards the governor. Okay, one circuit diagram how it will be works. I will discuss later. Okay. The movement of the needle controlled by the governor. It means regulating the flow of water with help of this governor. If the load on the turbines decreases, the governor pushes the needles into the nozzle, thereby reducing the quantity of water striking the buckets. Okay. So what it does, governor it will be pushes the needle into the nozzle, thereby reducing the quantity of water. Okay. Striking of bucket. Reverse action take place if the load on the turbine increases. It means reverse process means it will be increasing the water flow. Okay, so allowing the more water to flow. Okay. I will discuss what is governor, how it will be works. Just you have to note the point here. The governor which it will be regulate or control the flow of water. This is another one image, felt on wheel. And the one image it will be shown here, one more image. Okay. This schematic diagram, how and where the felt on turbines is placed. Okay, so if you are looking to this. This is the reservoir. Dam is constructed across this river, and water will be taken off through the penstock. Okay, and it will comes to the tail race. Tail race means operating the blade of turbine. The water it will comes down. No, that is tail race we are saying. Next one is propeller turbine. The propeller turbine is a reaction turbine used for low heads, 4 meter to 80 meters. Okay. And the high specific speed, 300 to the 1000 RPM. Okay. It is an axial flow device. Okay. Providing large flow area utilizing a large volume flow of water with low flow velocity. Here it is, figure is there. Just have to go through this. Next bit is characteristics of water turbines. Okay. First one is head. Okay, the operating head we can say. I will show you here. This head. If you are looking to this, you will come to know that gross head. the height which it will be there. Head. Related to this information, characteristics of turbines, the information related to the head we have to discuss here first. Okay. For heads up to 500 meters, reaction turbines of various types are used. For heads above 500 meters, up to about 2000 meters, Pelton wheels are used. Okay. This is a very important points related to the operating the head. Okay. So, in this head lower than 30 meters and for variable load operations, Kaplan or movable vane propeller types, turbines will be used. Heads less than 70 meters and for fairly constant load operation, fixed vane propeller type, head 70 to 500 meters, Francis turbines. Second one is efficiency at various loads. The efficiency curve of an impulse turbine is given here. The graph is plotted between percentage of full load, okay, and percentage efficiency. So if you are looking to the here, the percentage of full load at 80%, you will get the percentage of efficiency will be around more than 80. Okay, whereas percentage of load will be less, say it is 10 or 20, you will get less efficiency. Okay, the conclusion is here we have to operate with full load, then we will get the good efficiency. Efficiency curve of reaction turbines various types. In this graph, characteristics is plotted, percentage of full load and percentage of efficiency. Different reaction turbines are given here. Propeller type, Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine. Okay, by seeing this we can come to know that the higher percentage efficiency we will get in Kaplan turbine. Okay, let us have a discussion about the specific speed. Earlier also we come across the specific speed term. Okay, the term specific speed, earlier also it was there. Okay, let us have what is the meaning of specific speed. This is defined as that speed at which a turbine would run when developing 1 metric horsepower under a head of 1 meter. I repeat here, the speed which a turbine would run when developing 1 metric horsepower under a head of 1 meter. It can be shown that if NS, N and P and H, these are the notations, I will dictate here what are these things. NS is specific rotational speed. N is actual rotational speed, metric HP, P varies called in terms of HP, that is 736 watts, and H is the head in meters. Okay. Now, this is the equation. NS is equal to this equation. If you are substituting, you will get the specific rotational speed. Okay, revolution per minutes. Ordinary range of NS are as follows. Pelton wheel will get 12 to 70. Francis 80 to 420. Propeller and Kaplan type is 310 to 1000 RPM. Turbine setting. This is under falls under characteristics turbines. Okay, the setting of Paltan wheel, it will be done higher level, set at a higher level than the highest tail race level. Okay, as earlier I discussed here, the tail race, it will be nothing but tail race, it will be shown. I will show you where it is there. So here is the tail race. Paltan wheel, where it will be set, that discussion will be done in characteristics of turbines. Okay, I repeat here, the characteristics of turbine, when you are discussing, you have to discuss about the where the Paltan wheel is fitted and what above how much meter it is. About how many? Just a moment, I will tell you. Okay, just I will go to that slide and I will explain. It is a little bit facing difficult to explain here. Anyhow, tail race means it will be the water which it will be hits to the turbine's buckets, and after that it will becomes. Okay, this is the tail race. Okay, now the discussion, I will go to that slide and I will discuss. A Paltan wheel is always set at higher level than the highest tail race level. Okay, as against this Francis turbines. Okay, the level of this it will be in highest as compared to the Francis turbine. Okay, Francis turbine runner should be placed at a level very near or below the lowest tail race level. Next point discussion is runway speed. This is the maximum speed at which the turbine wheel would run under the worst condition of operation. Okay, I repeat here, runway speed is nothing but it is the maximum speed which turbine runs. Okay, under which condition? Under worst condition of operation, with all gates are open. Consider when it will be gates. Worst condition means the when all the gates open, so as to allow all possible water inflow under maximum head. Okay, the worst condition is corresponds to load on the generator being suddenly thrown off and governor falling to act. This must be taken into account, and the generator coupled to turbine must be able to withstand the full runway speed of the turbine under maximum permissible head. Okay, so I conclude here that the maximum speed at which the turbine wheel would run under the worst condition of operation. Okay, the worst condition corresponds to the load on the generator being suddenly thrown off and governor failing to act. It means governor, it will be not controlled. Even though you are turned off, but governor failing to act, then what it will be happens? It should be maximum speed. Thus, must be this must be taken into account, and the generator coupled to turbine must be able to withstand and full runway speed of the turbine under maximum permissible head. Okay, this is the discussion about runway speed. Okay, next class I will discuss about the governing of turbines.